Reclaim your energy and amplify your performance with self-care strategies in project management. Hey family, do you mind if I tell you a story? There was a group of mountaineers climbing set on this huge peak and eventually climbing in three groups. Group one, they were weary, disheartened. They even turned back, finding the journey too strenuous. Then there was group two. The group two, they contended on getting to the top of the air where the air was and the sun, and they enjoyed sandwiches and they sang, opting to stay where they are, or I should say were. Then there was this interesting group called group three. Group three, they were true mountaineers. They fixed their eyes on the summit, pressed on, pushed through all the challenges, and reached the top of the peak. Listen, family, in life, we're often going to find ourselves in one of these three moods. And in these three moods, we have to make a decision. Are we going to be group one, group two, or group three when we're going after our goals? Today's episode is entitled Breaking the Myth: Self-Care Does Not Mean Selfishness in Project Management. Again, breaking the myth: self-care does not mean selfish in project management. As you know, I have an 8-point framework. In these 8 points, I unpack kind of what we're going to talk about today about self-care. First of all, we need to unpack, what is self-care? Point number one, self-care is understanding that self-care refers to the deliberate, I'll say that again, family, the deliberate action taken to ensure well-being for project managers and their teams. Point number two, time management. Hold on, let me park right here parenthetically. Family, when I think about time management, I think about the importance of, I'm just going to be transparent. I'm not even going to give you no fluff or any gimmicks. Listen, I struggle with this, family. And the reason why I struggle with time management, because I want to be everything to everybody else except being what I need to be to myself so I can be my best version of self, and then I could be the best version to everyone else. So I started implementing certain tactics, or I should say techniques. When I'm in a meeting or I am on a call with someone, instead of trying to watch this, click over if I'm on a call and say, hey, let me call you back, I'm on the phone with such and such, I'll just call them back after I wrap up the call. When I'm in meetings, I put my phone in this thing they call Do Not Disturb. And see, what Do Not Disturb does for me, and then what I'm really realizing, family, is that people really don't want nothing but guess what they want? Your time. Time is an element that we will never get back, and I truly mean that. And so I started doing that, and I started watching how the telemarketer calls kind of slowed down, and people that was reaching out to me consistently as they normally would do kind of slowed down because they caught the message, they got the memo that, hey, he must be busy because it's sending me to voicemail, or maybe he's blocked me. But the point I'm trying to make, family, is that we have to apply time management skills to ensure both the project requirements as well as our personal time are well guarded as well as well managed. Let's move on to point number three. Oh, you see this balancing act. I'm almost about to go into the Karate Kid. But no, seriously, balancing act, family. We have to really learn and strike a balance between project demands and personal well-beings to avoid this thing that we call burnout. You know, burnout is really real. I didn't really believe it was really, truly real until one day I was sitting in my cubicle and I was eating at my cubicle. Only time I left my cubicle was to go to the bathroom because I wanted to make sure when you're exceptional, or I should say an exceptional project manager, you want to make sure you're meeting deliverables, you're answering calls, you're answering emails, you're answering teams, whatever the form of communication channel is, you want to be there and not miss a beat. But I will say this to you, family. Eventually, you will burn out. And burnout is not good because burnout, really what it means is that now you put yourself in a position as you're not as effective enough as you could be if you really took that time to step away, catch your breath, and rethink. It's sort of like I remember one time, family, when I got this email from someone, or we call it a nastygram in the world of project management. I got this nastygram, and this nastygram wanted to tell me every which way but right or left. It wanted to tell me who I wasn't and who I should be, and I wanted to, but I'm not even going to go there. But so I got up, and I walked away. And I want to thank the manager at that time because he's seen, I don't know if he's seen smoke coming off my head or what, but he walked over and he said, "You look troubled. What's going on?" And so I got up and I said, "Read this email." And he read, he said, "Oh, that was very disrespectful. You said, do you want to escalate it to me to handle?" I said, no. I'll handle that myself." He said, "Let me tell you this, Edward, what I'll ask you to do before you respond to that email, please get up and just take a walk around the building." And I was like, that's not going to do anything for me. I mean, I want to talk to this person. I want to give this person not a piece of my mind, my whole mind. And he said, no. Walk around the building one time. And that response that you were going to give that you already have formulated in your mind, don't give it just yet. If you have that same vigor and that same ferocity and frustration to respond with aggression and anger, I want you to walk around the building again." I said, "Listen, I'm not the smartest guy in the world, but I know you got me walking around the building too many times. I mean, I did work out early this morning, so you got me working out it again." He was like, "No, trust me on this." I said, "Okay, I'm going to trust you." So I walked around the building, family, and I was like, "Man, this ain't doing nothing." And I'm thinking about, "Ooh, I can't wait back to give them. Ooh, they gonna get this work. I promise you, they gonna get this work." And then I walked around again, just taking his consultation. And when I walked around again, and I'm thinking, I'm like, it reminded me of a quote: "Will this even matter in 5 years? What will it even matter in 6 months? Probably not." So let me respond with integrity. Let me respond with a sense of urgency. Let me respond and say, "Listen, I'm gonna talk facts. I'm not gonna talk emotions. We're gonna get to the bottom of this." And family, I came back and I responded to that email, copied my manager on it just to make sure that he was aligned with what I was doing. And he was impressed, not because of what I said, but it was how I said it within the email, that I was speaking in facts and not emotions. And the person that sent me the email, they were speaking more emotional. So I say all that to say this, family, it is a balancing act. And you have to make sure, I don't know why, I just love how that feels, like I'm in the Matrix or something. But anyway, I digress. But it is important, though, family, that you do that. And burnout will force you, I'm not kidding you, to respond in a way that you know that, and regarding that nasty gram, that it was a way to attack that person because you felt attacked. And you probably was being attacked. But you know, they always say two wrongs don't make a right. I don't know who said that, but I do know that it does make it right to respond in facts instead of emotions. Let's move on to point number four: stress management. Listen, being able to utilize stress management techniques enhances the resilience and maintains your focus during projects that are very challenging. One of the things I do, and I know I need to do more of it, but at least I've gotten started and I have to continue it and stay consistent, is I started meditating. There's an app out there. I'm not getting any plugs. I don't have a link or anything in there. Maybe I should, and maybe I will if you guys leave a comment and you're interested in. It's called Balance. And the reason, and this app called Balance, it's a meditation app, and it focuses on focus and other aspect of your mindset. And reason why I love it, I really love the focus aspect, because the more you're able to focus, the more driven you can be, the more, watch this, exceptional you can be. Let's move on to point number five: healthy boundaries. This is tough. I debated even sharing this with you, family, because I've done my best to have healthy boundaries. I've done my best to try to separate personal and work. When I mean separate personal and work, meaning is if we agreed that I'm gonna be here from 9 to 5 or 8 to 4 or 9 to 6 or whatever that time frame is then at that time I'm leaving. But I found myself in certain situations that I've extended that time much longer than it should be, but I thought that I was being exceptional, which I was, but at the same token, I wasn't thinking of my team, because if you think about it, if I'm sending my team emails late in the evening, they don't have the opportunity to respond, because now it's not like I'm gonna get a response in the evening anyway. So I might as well wait until the morning where they're gonna be there, they're gonna be fresh and ready to respond. So it's basically establishing and respecting personal and professional boundaries to maintain a healthy work-life balance. Point number six: team morale. Hey, boosting team morale through self-care practicing and fostering a positive project environment. I don't know if you've ever worked in a toxic project environment. It is draining. I mean, it's one of those things where on Sunday, your heart, I remember Les Brown talked about it, where you know you have to go into work on Monday and it just feel like your chest is just tightening up because you like, oh man, what am I gonna walk into when I walk in on Monday? What are the meetings that people are gonna be just dysfunctional on purpose and not trying to collaborate and work on a common goal, which is our outcome and making sure this project is on time, on schedule, within scope, and approved quality. So family, having a good project working environment is important. No matter of fact, it's valued. And when you lose project managers or you lose project coordinators or project team members like stakeholders, it's because of the environment. A lot of people want to point to leadership or point to a financial number. I'm gonna tell you this. Yes, money is important. I'm like Zig Ziglar. It's up there with air. But being in a great and amazing work environment that fosters, self-care, that foster that teamwork as far as a collaboration approach, instead of a silo or pointing fingers, is healthy. Point number seven, mental health awareness. Hey, listen, being able to recognize the significance of mental health and its impact on project success is important as well, family. You have to know your limits. If you don't know your limits, you have to expose yourself to a limit in which when you say, hey, listen, this is not, I'm getting in a mental space where this is just not adding up. This is not working for me anymore. And I need to just take a step back so I can take two steps forward. That sometimes has to work, family. Now, I do want to get on the other side of this before you guys leave any comments in there. Sometimes you do have to push through, but even though you're pushing through, you don't push through recklessly. You push through with a plan and you work that plan because you know what? If you plan to fail, what? You fail to plan. Let's move on to my last and final point. Point A, sustainable success. Listen, being able to acknowledge the sustained project success hinges, and I do mean hinges, like on a door, on the well-being of the project stakeholders as well as the project manager in entirety. Hey, family, I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Hey, hit that like, subscribe, leave a comment. I want to know what you guys thought about today's episode. Until next time, I'm out.